I might be giving off the impression that it is currently a very early morning, but it is in fact the complete opposite, which is the reason I think I felt drawn to pick up this book, The 5 AM Club. I'm always going in and out of my reading stage, and right now I feel like I want to get back into it. I thought this would be a good book to start with. I'm really struggling with my mornings right now, and I don't think 5 AM is the goal that I'm looking for. I feel like that's still the middle of the night. I think 7 AM, maybe eventually pushing it to 6, but realistically right now, I feel like even 8 would be really nice. The temperature has suddenly dropped once again, so I was advised against driving today. Apparently the roads are meant to freeze up, but I think it's fine. However, I am not. Like, my eye keeps watering. It's so cold and windy. I think it feels like it's minus 14 or something crazy, so I thought it was a perfect excuse to go and get something nice and warm. I did not realize that there are two types of the red bean porridge. The normal one is the sweet version, which is what I was kind of expecting today. And then the other one that I didn't know about is the salty one, which I found out after today's lunch. So it's salty and served with kimchi, which is not really to my liking. It was very filling though, like a very filling lunch. I don't need anything else, but I do wish it was the sweet version. I did get my hair cut the other day, and I'm thinking that this will be the last chop that I do. I'm thinking of maybe growing it out, but we'll see how far I go. But that's my current thoughts on it. I also want to show you my jewelry pieces that I have on today, because this video, I'm very happy to say, is in collaboration again with Ana Luisa, who are my go-to jewelry brand. I want to say about 95% of the jewelry that I own right now is from Ana Luisa, so anything that you see me wearing in these videos is probably from them. I decided I was gonna go with gold today. I felt like it matched my outfit well, and I love all these pieces. And I'm also very excitedly waiting for new pieces from Ana Luisa. I will show them here because they'll be coming this week. And these are gonna be my self Valentine's gifts. I feel like the new year just started, but just around the corner we have Valentine's Day. It is creeping in on us, and this Valentine's is all about self-care, self-love. It's so nice spoiling yourself with a nice little gift, and Ana Luisa is one that you can purchase and know that it's gonna be with you for a very long time. All their pieces are of high quality and are so long lasting, so you know that you're investing in long lasting jewelry. And I can vouch on this because some of my pieces I've had for over a year and they look exactly the same. They're tarnish free, the quality is unmatched, and it means that I have now stopped shopping at all those cheap jewelry stores that you know the jewelry is gonna break and not last long, which just isn't worth it. And to give you even more peace of mind, Ana Luisa has a 2-year warranty on all the pieces that you shop from them, so that gives you even more confidence about the quality of the jewelry that you'll be buying. They have such a huge selection. What I've just showed you is only a tiny fraction. They have gold and silver. They have something for everyone. So go and have a look if you are interested and wanting to buy yourself something nice, a nice treat for Valentine's Day coming up. And you can never go wrong with some pretty jewelry. So I have a link for you, and the link is in the description box. Go check out Ana Luisa, and a huge thank you to them for collaborating with me on this video. I feel a bit scared going back out into the cold. However, I do have an urge to go and buy some books, especially after we talked about them this morning, because reading self-help books are all good, but I don't feel like it's going to help me get back into the swing of reading again. I feel like I need some non-self-help books, some fiction books that would be nice, and my go-to place is Kyobo. It's a really nice bookstore, and they do have a good little English section too. But I didn't do any research before of like recommendations, because their selection there is kind of small. So I thought I would just go and see what kind of spoke to me. And honestly, there wasn't a lot, but I did get this one book, Verity by Colleen Hoover. I just like this author. I've read a few of her books before, so I thought I couldn't go wrong with another one of hers. And I can just use this kind of like kickstart my reading phase once again. I have never been great in the kitchen, but that is something that I'm actively trying to get better at right now. Especially these days, I feel motivation to cook. So I'm like, if I feel like I want to, I have to take advantage of it. And it's actually been going well so far. I've definitely had some dishes that my husband has very reluctantly ate, and me too, like it's not been enjoyable. But it's been going well, so it's been a lot more fun. Of course, I want to eat something that actually tastes good. Salmon dish is nice and easy. I feel like you can't go too wrong. I normally do a grilled salmon, but I need to go grocery shopping. I don't have any veggies, so a salmon rice bowl with so much seaweed. I just recently have gotten back into ballet, which has been really nice. It's been something that I haven't taken like an actual class for, it's been about 10 years. Obviously I've done other dance classes, so it's not like I've been completely out, but doing like a proper set ballet class has been forever. So it's been really nice to get back into it. This is gonna be my fourth lesson today. But ballet has never been my favorite dance. Like it's always been my least favorite, to be honest. I've always loved like tap and jazz. That was definitely like more my thing. And we just did ballet because you have to for like technique. However, because I can't get those type of classes here and it's just more on the side of like street jazz, hip hop kind of thing, that's why I feel myself like going back and finding these ballet classes. This is why I could never cut my hair as a kid, because it had to be able to go into a bun. I think we're just gonna do a ponytail. I do think it's nice to have these things though, going back, getting into hobbies. This would never be allowed. Fun clips and jewelry. I have a lot more fun with it now as an adult. And a scrunchie. That will do. It is now 10:30. I am so tired. I feel like this day has just gone on and on and on. But I did have a very good ballet class. I feel poised and lifted, but also just exhausted. So I am gonna head to bed because I'm forced to wake up very early tomorrow, which is a good thing, but I need to get sleep ASAP to feel even remotely okay. A little reminder that if you've been inspired by the jewelry that I showed you today, then do check out Ana Luisa. And the link is in the description box to go and have a little look around. Treat yourself this Valentine's because we all deserve it. Thank you so much for watching if you made it till this point. I look forward to seeing you again next week. Bye.